in a tit-for-tat row over satellite photographs showing land reclamation work by China on several contested reefs. The Chinese Foreign Ministry claimed that the Philippines itself had engaged in large-scale construction of military and civil facilities on islands in the sea for many years.
Tit-for-tat refers to petty acts of revenge between people. For example, with roommates, one roommate doesn't squeeze out the sponge after washing the dishes, so the other roommate leaves a grape sitting right in the middle of the counter. And then the other roommate does some other little petty thing to annoy the other roommate. That's tit for tat. And usually it's considered to be possibly a little immature, but within the realm of ethics, because people need to sort of create their own space, and if somebody's violating their space, usually they want to give some message to the person not to do that. So literally, tit for tat means tip for tap, or blow for blow. It's an old-fashioned expression. A tip being a light touch, a tap being another light touch. And you can see how little children will do that. One of them will tap the other child, and the other will tap the child back. And next thing you know, they're hitting each other, right? That's how it works. So in a more broad sense, it means giving an equivalent action in return for some negative action against yourself, or what we call repayment in kind for some injury, retaliation. A lot of the hijinks on reality shows that you see is really just tit for tat. One person borrows a shirt from someone else, and then it ends up with a little stain on it. And then the other person ends up short cheating their bed to get back at them. And then, you know, we kind of think it's funny, and maybe it is funny, but, you know, maybe it's not so funny after all. There was the series Jackass, and, you know, I think half of those guys at this point are dead because of pranks they pulled on other people, or their crazy things that they did that they thought were pranks, or they thought were just having fun, that ended up going bad on them. Tit for tat doesn't have to be retaliation or revenge. It can also be the idea of one hand washes the other. You do something nice for someone else, they do something nice for you. So tell you what, I'll let you borrow some of my albums, and you let me borrow your big boomer speakers for a week, tit for tat. Or tell you what, let me go out for a spin in your car, and I'll put some gas in it. I'll put half a tank of gas in it just for a half an hour ride, tit for tat.
A storm blew up over claims that the German intelligence services were helping America to spy on European companies and individuals.
A blow-up, a storm, refers to getting into a heated argument over something. The idea of a storm being very windy, metaphor for an argument. Blow up means a lot of wind coming into existence. So, if an argument blew up, that means that people just started arguing somewhat unexpectedly. So blow up over something is when there's a strong or violent outburst as an emotion or excitement, or could be a storm of tears, crying, or it could be a violent disturbance or upheaval as a political, social, or domestic affairs, a storm of protest. So, for example, my daughter, she blew up a storm when she got rejected at Harvard. She still got accepted to Yale, so I couldn't see what the problem was. But to her, it was very upsetting. In the Middle East, during the Arab Spring, a lot of protesters, they blew up a storm over human rights, which unfortunately ended up turning into civil wars in several of the countries. Nowadays, the news media, they blow up a storm over every little piece of new information. The other day, one of the presidential candidates, he said that he had gotten accepted to West Point, and it turns out that he wasn't accepted to West Point. All he got, apparently, according to him, was an informal promise. So they're blowing up a storm saying that he lied when he made that claim. ESL-FullSteamAhead.com